Welcome to Dudier Academy. Today I am discussing multiple choice questions from hematology. This is very important because in competitive examinations, a lot of questions are asked from this part. So I'm starting. Question number one: patients with pernicious anemia are treated with options: oral iron, oral folic acid, parenteral iron, parenteral vitamin B12. Patients with pernicious anemia are treated with. Right answer is parenteral vitamin B12. So on giving the explanation of this pernicious anemia, it is due to the absence of gastric intrinsic factor which impairs the absorption of vitamin B12 from intestine. The gastric intrinsic factor, it is normally present in the stomach secretions. And if there is absence of this gastric intrinsic factor, pernicious anemia occurs, and that impairs the absorption of vitamin B12 from intestine. Okay, intrinsic factor is responsible for the absorption of vitamin B12, and vitamin B12 is required for maturation of erythrocytes. So vitamin B12 is administered by injection or IV infusion for management of pernicious anemia. Also, you cannot, in the absence of intrinsic factor, oral vitamin B12 supplements will not get absorbed. So, parenteral administration is needed in case of pernicious anemia. So, here the question is, patients with pernicious anemia are treated with. The right answer here is parenteral vitamin B12. Next, second question. A patient with anemia is feeling tired due to the tissue deficiency of. Options: carbon dioxide, oxygen, factor 8, antibodies. The right answer is oxygen. Anemia occurs when there is fewer RBCs, red blood cells, or not enough hemoglobin in blood. And hemoglobin is the iron-rich protein in RBC. It carries oxygen from lungs to all parts of body. So fatigue occurs if there is inadequate oxygen levels in the tissues that should have been carried by hemoglobin. Okay, so here the question is, patient with anemia is feeling tired due to a tissue deficiency of oxygen. Next question. Hemophilia B is caused by the deficiency of. Options: factor 9, factor 8, factor 7, factor 6. Hemophilia B is caused by the deficiency of factor 9. Hemophilia, it is a bleeding disorder that slows the blood clotting process, and the major types are hemophilia A and hemophilia B. So hemophilia A is caused by the deficiency of factor 8. It is also known as classic hemophilia. And hemophilia B is caused by the deficiency of factor 9. It is also known as Christmas factor. Factor 9 is also known as Christmas factor. So hemophilia B is also known as Christmas disease. So here the question, hemophilia B is caused by the deficiency of factor 9. So the fourth question, aspirin prolongs bleeding time by inhibiting the synthesis of. Aspirin prolongs bleeding time by inhibiting the synthesis of. Options: clotting factors in liver, prostacycline in vascular endothelium, cyclic AMP in platelets, thromboxane A2 in platelets. Here the right answer is thromboxane A2 in platelets, by inhibiting the synthesis of thromboxane A2 in platelets. So what is aspirin? It is an antiplatelet drug, and it prolongs the bleeding time by inhibiting the aggregation of platelets through inhibition of thromboxane A2. Through inhibition of thromboxane A2, aspirin inhibits the aggregation of platelets and thus prolongs the bleeding time. Then what is thromboxane A2? It is one of the chemicals that is released by platelets that makes them stick together. Okay. And what happens is aspirin prevents the formation of this chemical thromboxane A2 by blocking an enzyme in platelet which is called cyclooxygenase. Okay, so thus aspirin prolongs the bleeding time. So here the question is, aspirin prolongs bleeding time by inhibiting the synthesis of thromboxane A2 in platelets. Then question number 5. Normal value of iron in the blood. Options 20 to 50 microgram per deciliter, 50 to 150 microgram per deciliter, 200 to 300 microgram per deciliter, 300 to 500 microgram per deciliter. Normal value of iron in blood. The right answer is 50 to 150 microgram per deciliter. Okay, normal value of iron in blood is 50 to 150 microgram per deciliter. Next, question number 6. Hemophilia is a Dash disorder. Hemophilia is a Dash disorder. Options X-linked dominant, X-linked recessive, autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive. The right answer is X-linked recessive disorder. Hemophilia is a X-linked recessive disorder. So hemophilia A and hemophilia B are inherited in an X-linked recessive pattern because the genes are located on X chromosome. So the question here was hemophilia is a X-linked recessive disorder. Next question. Commonly seen leukemia in children is. Commonly seen leukemia in children is. Options acute myelocytic leukemia AML, acute lymphocytic leukemia ALL, then chronic myelocytic leukemia and chronic lymphocytic leukemia. Right answer is acute lymphocytic leukemia. Acute leukemia occurs primarily in children. And this acute lymphocytic leukemia is the most common childhood cancer and usually begins between the ages of 2 to 5 years. Between the ages of 2 to 5 years it begins. So this acute lymphocytic leukemia constitute 80% of this childhood leukemia cases. And here the question is commonly seen leukemia in children. The right answer is acute lymphocytic leukemia. Next question number 8. A person with one of the following blood groups of is considered as a universal recipient. Question number 8. A person with one of the following blood groups is considered as a universal recipient. Options A, A, B, O, B. The right answer is A, B. So the blood group AB blood group is considered as universal recipient and O blood group is considered as universal donor. Then question number 9. Normal prothrombin time is. Options 8 to 10 seconds, 11 to 13.5 seconds, 12.5 to 15 seconds, 15 to 30 seconds. The right answer is 11 to 13.5 seconds. Prothrombin time is an actual amount of time that it takes blood to clot. That is, this test indicates the proper functioning of the coagulation factors and the coagulation process. And the normal prothrombin time is 11 to 13.5 seconds. Then question number 10, normal bleeding time is. Options 1 to 3 minutes, 6 to 10 minutes, 3 to 6 minutes, 10 to 12 minutes. Normal bleeding time. The right answer is 3 to 6 minutes. Bleeding time, it is a screening test that is used to detect the platelet disorders or evaluate for any capillary defects and determine the client's ability to stop bleeding. So the normal bleeding time, that is almost 3 to 8 minutes in adults, considered as 3 to 8 minutes. Here in this option, the right answer is 3 to 6 minutes. So thank you. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you like this video, and also you can give your comments in the comment box.